सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां हालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावदीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः धातुब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृसुबन्तादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः नारायणः परोव्यक्ता दण्डमव्यक्तसम्भवो मण्डस्यान्तस्तु मे लोकाः सप्तद्वीपा च मे दिने The last class we saw the 14th shloka of the 5th chapter, the Kartruttam na Karmani, Lokasi, no sorry, 13th. Sarva Karmani Manasa Sanyasyaste Sukham Vashi Navadvare Pure Dehi Naiva Kurvanna Karyan. Sarva Karmani Manasa Sanyasyaste Sukham Vashi is one happily stays in the Sharira Navadvare Pure Dehi Sukhamaste. Without doing anything and not causing anyone else to do. Because this Atma is Asanga, has no Kartrutva Bhoktrutva, and not having Kartrutva does not have Karayitva also. Thereby, Sarva Karmani Sanyasya, having giving up all karmas, and Manasa, Manasa is Viveka Buddhya Visa, Viveka Buddhya, having given up through Viveka Buddhi, because I, as Asanga Atma, cannot have any karma, thereby one drops all karma and remains happily, blissfully in the Sharira, which is nine gated body, so to say. Kincha, further kincha, nakartrutva nakarmani lokasya srijati prabhuhu nakarmaphala sanyogam svabhavastu pravartate. So, prabhu is the karta. Here, prabhu, Ishara or Nirguna Brahma, even Atma. Brahma, we will take Brahma, so interpretation can vary. Prabhuhu, Brahma, lokasya kartruttvam na srujati, karmani na srujati, karma phala sanyogam na srujati. Srujati, he does not create. Brahma, saguna or nirguna, however you want to take it, he does not create the kartruttvam. We say that the prapancha has come from Brahma. So Brahma has created this prapancha. Okay, so far so good. How about the kartrutva bhava of the jiva? Does he create that also? So jiva he has created. How has he created jiva? He has entered the sharira as jiva. Anene jivatmana anupravishya. Having entered this sharira as jiva. So Ishvara himself has entered into the sharira as jiva. But what about kartrutva? He is an akarta. In fact, Shuddha Atma is not a karta. We bring in Maya to explain how Nirguna Brahma became the Srishti Karta. So Kartrutvam is not made by him. Atma does not have Kartrutvam. And karma also is not created by him. The objects are also the karma for which the karta engages in. So karma, what is karma really? In Sanskrit, in Panini, Vyakrana, this kartu ipsitam karma. Karma is that which is most desired through an action by a karta. So kartrutva bhava has to be there for one to do karma. And we have to do kriya, so to perform a kriya. And why does anyone perform a kriya? Kriya is performed for something which is desired. And what is most desired through a kriya, by definition, that is called as karma. Kartu ipsitatam karma, that which is most desired in a kriya is called as karma. How about that karma? Lokasya, loka here is the person or the an individual or a group of people. So loka. Lokasya kartrutvam prabhu na srujati, and similarly karmani api na srujati. He does not create karma also, meaning that which is most desirable. He does not create a kama in you for you to desire a kama. Kama as in kamya vastu. So that is called as karma. You desire on your own. You have kartrutvam and then you desire on your own. He did not bring about the desired object for you. What you desire, he didn't bring that for you. So, and what about karma phala sanyoga? Once you are a karta and you engage in a kriya for a particular karma, vishaya here, then this karma will generate, that kriya, that action will generate a phala, karma phala. And that phala has to be associated with you. He does not do that also. He does not create an association also. If you have kartrutvam, then bhoktrutvam will come by, automatically it will come. He does not have to create separately. He does not have to create sanyoga. We say chetana vastu is there for you to, the punya papa to be granted to you. But that is the vyavastha. He did not create that sanyoga for you. Neither did he give you kartrutvam, nor karma, nor the karma phala sanyoga. Then how does this vyavastha work? Then how is it that all of this kartrutva come in, and how karma work, comes about, and then one engages in a kriya, and thereby karma phala is born and karma phala sanyoga is born? How is this vyavastha possible? So there he says, svabhava tu pravartate. Svabhava here is prakriti. What has been said earlier as gunaha guneshu vartante. The gunas engage in guna. The whatever is created, the panchamahabhutas and their karyas, they engage in each other. And if they engage in each other, then this kartrutva, bhoktrutva, all that is the side effect of that for an ajnani. For one who has ajnana, more will be said later, but here we'll see this much. Svabhava means prakriti. Prakriti is upravartate. Svabhava, which is maya. Maya pravartate. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says there. What does he say with svabhava? Svabhava, svabhava, svabhava. One's own bhava. What is that? Avidya lakshana prakriti hi maya pravartate. Daivi hi maya. So there he says that ityadna vakshamana, which will be said in the 7th chapter. What is the svabhava? That svabhava is prakriti. Prakriti vashat. Everything is under the control of prakriti. Of course, that prakriti is jada, which is called as pradhana by sankhyas, but in the presence of the chetana vastu, the nirguna brahma presence makes prakriti act. And thereby the combination is called as Ishvara, and we call that maya, that svabhava, as Shakti of Bhagavan, of Shakti of Ishvara. So Prabhuhu na kartrutvam. So na kartrutvam, second case. Na karmani, in second case. Lokasya Prabhuhu srijati. Kasyakarma svabhavah tu pravartate. So two verbs are there. We make two sentences. Prabhuhu kartrutvam na srijati, and karmani na srijati. Lokasya kartrutvam na srijati. Karmani na srijati. And karma phala sanyoga also na srijati. Na srijati. So srijati you have to bring in anuvratti, because na is there three times. You have to make three sentences. So, and svabhava tu pravartate is the next sentence. Paramarthatastu, in reality, in the highest reality, what is the case? Nadatte kasyachit papam nachaiva sukrutam vibuhu ajnanenavrutam jnananti namuhyanti jantavah. So jantavah tena muhyanti. They, jantus, the creatures, are deluded. Muhyanti, it works on itself as though, muhdhatu. So although it is kartari prayoga, your translation will be they delude themselves or they are deluded. It will sound like karmani. Tena, tena kena, ajnanena. Ajnanena, yena ajnanena, jnanam avrutam bhavati, tena ajnanena jantava muyanti. That ajnana which causes the covering, the veil over jnana, jnana is swarupa. One's own swarupa jnana is covered by which ajnana, due to that same ajnana, a person is deluded. So where there is avrati, avarana, there vikshepa is obvious. Because vikshepa will happen when avarana is there. Tattva is covered and then there is projection. So what is this said for? Paramartatastu, this is the reality. Swabhavastu pravartate, that is explained here. Vibhuhu kasyachit, the way it is said here, lokasya, similarly kasyachit, lokasya, kasyachit lokasya. Vibhuhu, vibhuhu is this, vyapakatva vibhuhu, vibhu means all pervasive tattva, that brahma tattva vibhuhu is the karta here. Karta as in vyakrana, in vyakrana it is a karta, it is not really karta. Vibhuhu kasyachit papam na adatte, na adatte, na cha eva sukrutam adatte. So he does not, here it was said, na srujati, he does not create kartrutva karma and then by bhoktrutvam also, karma phala sanyoga, one does not create. Atma does not create, brahmatma or Ishvara does not create brahma. Then papa, he takes away papa, so harati papani iti harihi, we say hari, who is hari? One who takes away your papa. So with that kind of a questioning, if you say that, how do you say he does not create this yavastha? He takes away papa. So you are saying that he does not make you a karta, but he takes away your papa. No, that is not paramarthata, he does not take away papa also, kasyachit. So if a person thinks I am a bhakta, my papa will be taken away. No, it will not be taken away. Because Brahma has nothing to do with it, really. So kasyachit papam na adatte, so apurvaka da, and thereby na adatte, apurvaka da will mean opposite of giving. So he does not take away somebody's papa, and sukrutam, sukrutam is samyak, sushtukrutam, sushtukrutam is punya. What about punya? No, he does not grant punya also, he does not take away that also. So here since it is adatte, we have to do anuruti of adatte. Otherwise, we can say it does not give punya. Let's see what Bhagavad Pada says. Na caiva adatte sukrutam. So sukrutam also, he does not take away punya papa. He does not give anything. Since he has not given you kartrutva, he cannot take away bhoktrutva also. You are the karta, you do the bhoga. So here kartrutva and the sanyoga of bhoga is mentioned. And what about bhoga being taken away? That also he does not do. If you offer the punya to the Lord also, he can't take away. He can't. Lord as in paramarthata. We have seen paramarthata. Vyavahara, in vyavaharika satta, yes. We have a vyavastha, we say yes. Bhagavan will take away your papa. You have to earn punya for that. All that is true. But paramarthata, in reality, this vibhutattva, all that is done through the maya shakti, prakriti, svabhavastu pravartate, that pradhana tattva, that is sitting in between. Paramarthata, all that vyavastha is not there. Only from vyavaharika drishti, we say that such a vyavastha is there. But from the angle of paramarthika angle, in the highest reality, this Ishvara is no longer there, Sagunattvam is no longer there, and thereby kasyachit papam. So harihi, when he is seen with a body mind sense complex, that kind of a hari where you do upasana, there it is all right. But then vibhu harihi, that hari whose reality is vibhutvam, he will not do anything because there is nothing other than him. What will he take away? So when that aikya is established, that aikya does not have anything other than itself for to give or to take away. So nadatte kasyachit vibhuhu kasyachit papam na adatte nacha सुकृतम एव आदत्ते एव देन व्हाट इज व्यवस्था अज्ञानेन आवृतम ज्ञानम तेन मुह्यन्ति जंतव ऑल दिस व्यवस्था इज एक्सप्लेन फॉर एन अज्ञानी दैट सच अ व्यवस्था डज एग्जिस्ट फॉर ओनली फॉर एन अज्ञानी इट इज एन एक्सप्लेनेशन गिवन एंड देयर बाय अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ अज्ञान अलोन ऑल दिस इज हैपनिंग विभुः कश्चित् पापं न आदत्ते एंड सुकृतं न च एव आदत्ते अज्ञानेन आवृतं ज्ञानम् अज्ञानेन आवृतं भवति अज्ञानेन आवृतं भवति एंड तेन अज्ञानेन जंतवः तेन मुह्यन्ति और तेन जंतवः मुह्यन्ति सुकृतमादत्ते विभुः ब्रह्मतत्त्व अज्ञानेन आवृतं ज्ञानं तेन जन्तवः मुह्यन्ति देयर इज नो एंड इन कंटिन्यूएशन आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज अ देयर इज नो संगति भाष्य हियर So 16 श्लोका से ज्ञाने न तु तद् ज्ञानं येषां नाशितम् आत्मनः येषां आदित्यवज्ञानं प्रकाशयति तत्परम् तो ज्ञानेन तु ज्ञानेन तु तद् अज्ञानं ज्ञाने तु तद् अज्ञानं नाशितम् आत्मनः अज्ञानं नाशितम् तद् अज्ञानं येषां नाशितं भवति सो दि आत्मनः अज्ञानं वन्स ओन अज्ञान और अज्ञान ऑफ आत्मा देयर आत्मना इज कर्मणि षष्ठी देयर आत्मनः अज्ञानं सो अज्ञान ऑफ आत्मा रिलेटिंग टू दिस आत्मा बिकॉज आत्मा इज ए विषय एंड देयर बाय इट इज अ कर्म ऑफ अज्ञान तेषां सो फॉर हूम दिस अज्ञान इज डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय वॉट ज्ञानेन तु तद् अज्ञानं येषां नाशितं भवति आत्मनः अज्ञानं येषां नाशितं भवति तेषां ज्ञानं प्रकाशयति सो आदित्यवत् सन् रिवील समथिंग इन द Or rather, everything becomes revealed in the presence of the sun, and then we say, sun has revealed it. Sun has revealed everything. Sun has shone upon all the objects of the world, and thereby he is shining upon all, and then everything is seen. Similarly, adityavat, jnanam, jnana is the karta, jnanam, tat param prakashati, param tattvam, tat. तत्परम तत्त्वं प्रकाशयति देयर आर वेरियस वेज टू डू इट आई विल कीप इट सिंपल तत्परम ब्रह्म सो परम इज व्हाट द हाईएस्ट तत्व प्रकाशयति इट मेक्स इट रिवील ज्ञान मेक्स द परम तत्व टू बी रिवील प्रकाशयति कॉजेस टू बी रिवील सो प्रकाश हियर इज इट लाइट्स अप बट देन इट कॉजेस टू लाइट अप देयर बाय ज्ञान मेक्स इट पॉसिबल हाउ वाया destruction of ajnana. So prakasha yati is said causative. What it does is that it shines upon, jnana shines upon how the jnana takes away ajnana. And thereby it is said that atma tattva it reveals. how does it reveal? It causes the Atma Tattva to be revealed, so causative. And how it causes? By removing Ajnana, which is covering. So if you just take away the covering, the Atma Tattva shines up on its own, Param Tattva, that shines up because it is self-effulgent. It is covered by a veil, that veil has to be removed, and Jnana removes the veil of Ajnana, thereby Param Prakashayati. Yesham Nashitam Yesham Jnanena Tuttad Ajnanam Nashitam Bhavati. Tesham Atmanaha Ajnanam. So Atmanaha Ajnanam. Tat Jnanena Tu Tat Atmanaha Ajnanam Yesham Nashitam Bhavati. Or Yesham Tat Atmanaha Ajnanam Nashitam Bhavati Tesham Adityavat Jnanam Tatparam Prakashayati. तत् परम तत्त्वं प्रकाशयति. यत् परम ज्ञानं प्रकाशितं, दैट परज्ञान विच इज प्रकाशितं, विच इज रिवील्ड. व्हाट इज दैट? दैट ज्ञान इज देयर चित्त स्वरूप ज्ञान. सो इट दिस ज्ञान इज भावे व्युत्पत्ति. ऑल्दो इट इज कर्म फॉर दी सेंटेंस हियर, still that jnana, param jnanam, adityavat tesham adityavat jnanam, so that chid swarupa jnana itself, here karane, but then the param jnanam, this jnanam can also go with param. So adityavat tat param jnanam prakashayati, thereby this jnana will become chid swarupa. Otherwise you have to take it as karane, and that karana reveals. Or in the sentence it will be, I'm talking about vyutpatti, vyutpatti of karane vyutpatti or bhave vyutpatti. But in the sentence, this jnana is a karta. Vyutpatti wise, this is karne. Otherwise, if you take it as param jnanam prakashayati, tat jnanam, this jnana can go with tat also, and you can say adityavat tat param jnanam prakashayati. There jnana will become chitswarupa, and thereby bhave vyutpatti. All these are possible. The meaning is still the same, that jnana reveals chitswarupa Paramatma. Yet param jnanam prakashitam. Here is taking a jnanam is which is revealed. So thereby this jnana is what? Is chitswarupa jnana. So I'll just mention the other way so that we know the possibility. Tat param jnanam prakashayati. So thereby this tat will go with this jnana here and karane. And then this jnana will become bhavya yutpatti, and thereby chit swarupa. Yet param jnanam prakashitam, which is what Bhagavan Bhashyakara is saying, this param jnanam yet prakashitam, which is revealed. What is that param jnanam which is revealed? Or this can also mean, which is the earlier that jnana which is, I think it is preferably the second construct, where yet param jnanam prakashitam, that which is revealed. So prakashitam. And that has an anvaya with the 17th shloka. Tadbuddhayastadatmanastannishtastatparayanah gacchantya punaravrittim jnana nirdhuta kalmashah. So tadbuddhaya tasmin buddhi yesham te tadbuddhaya tadatmanah sahayva atma yesham te. So that is a possible construct here. We'll see more in the we'll try to see in the bhashya. Tadatmana is saha or tat also. Tad brahma atma yesham te tadatmana or saha paramatma atma yesham te there tadatmana. Tan nishtaha tasmin nishtha yesham te tan nishtaha jantatparayanha tateva param ayanam येषां ते तत्परायणाः गच्छन्ति. वेर गच्छन्ति? अपुनरावृत्तिं गच्छन्ति. दे अटेन नॉन रिटर्न. व्हाट डज इट मीन? डबल निगेशन. or rather punaha is saying again and a is negating, so non-written. They attain non-written, thereby punaha is kind of a it's a repetition, and a is what it is negating the repetition, so not really double negative, but a is taking away this whatever is said punaha avrutti, it is taking away this punah punyattum, it is taking away by saying that they will not have written, so they will have non-written means they will not have written, so they will not be born again in samsara. That is the meaning. Those who are sadbuddhaya, brahma buddhi, those who have brahma buddhi, those who consider as brahma as atma, those who are committed complete to brahman and remain there, those who are tatparayanaha, they think that this is the only destination, there is the only purushartha, there is no other purushartha, they do not get janma again. And why? So how have they become all of this? So there is a hetu garbha visheshanaya jnana nirdhuta kalmashaha santaha. So being jnana nirdhuta kalmasha, being this kalmasha is papa or some kind of a flaw, the defects, what are these? These are in the form of ajnana and ajnana karya. They have gone away, nirdhuta. So jnanena nirdhutaha kalmasha yeshamte. Those for whom kalmashas have been removed through jnana, thereby that becomes the hetu for them to become all of this, and apunaravrutti, for attaining apunaravrutti. Tadbuddhya tadatmanaha tannishtha tatparayana, or we can say that this is not the hetu, all of these others are hetu for being jnana nirdhuta kalmasha. Either way it is possible. Apunaravrutti gacchanti. येषां ज्ञानेन नाशितम् आत्मनः अज्ञानम् ते पंडिताः कथं तत्त्वं पश्यन्ति इत्युच्यते. हौ इन विच मैनर, हौ डू दीस पंडिताः, हु आर दीस पंडिताः, आत्मनः अज्ञानम् येषां नाशितम्, फॉर हुम दी आत्म अज्ञान, अज्ञान ऑफ द आत्मा हैज गॉन, हैज बीन डिस्ट्रॉयड, बाय व्हाट? बाय ज्ञान और थ्रू ज्ञान. दे आर पंडिताः. And these panditas, katham tattvam pashyanti, how do they cognize this tattva? How do they know the reality, tattva? Vidya vinesam panne brahmane gavi hastini shuni chaivashvapa kecha panditas samadarshinah. They are samadarshinah. Panditas are those whose ajnana is destroyed, atma ajnana is destroyed through jnana, and they are samadarshinah. Samadarshinah is brahmadarshinah. So samatvam, samatva is yoga, samatvam yoga muchyate, so samatva is yoga. And what is that samatva? Samatva, that brahma which is the basis for everything, everything is an appearance of brahma, thereby sarvam brahma. So all idam sarvam brahma. Therefore, samadarshina is brahmadarshina. Samam darshitum shilam yesham te samadarshina. And what is that samam? What is that tattvam pashyanti? So, tattvadarshina. Tattvam pashyanti, who are those? Panditas are samadarshina. Pandita samadarshina. And samadarshina is our tattvadarshina. Tattva is brahma. So, brahmadarshina. Brahmadarshitum shilam yesham. They don't see as an objectified brahma. But everywhere, whatever they see, that is resolved into Brahma by Bhada Samanadikaranyam. None of this exists other than me, other than Brahma, through Karya Karana, Abheda, or through Mithyatva Nischaya, or through any Prakriya. As long as you can land on Abheda and Mithyatva Nischaya is there in everything that is cognized, thereby Tattva alone is seen. There is nothing other than me which is existent, nothing other than Brahmatma. And as a list, there is there are few things which are listed. What are these? Vidya vinne sampanne. They Pandita Samadarshina, unto what do they have the vision of equality of that Brahma? Whether they see a Vidyavinaya Sampanna, Brahmana who is well qualified, qualified with Vidya and Vinaya. Vidya is all kind of scholarship is possible with Vidya, and Vinaya who has humility. So one who is Vinaya Sampanna and Vidya Sampanna, towards that kind of a person there is Samatva Bhava. Brahma is appearing in the form of this Brahmana or this scholar. So we say all the vibhuti which is there is Bhagwan's vibhuti. And Bhagwan says elsewhere, in another chapter he is going to say that wherever you see yad yad vibhuti mattvam, wherever you see vibhuti, whatever speciality you see, very unique, all that is me, that is my manifestation. Gives us sampling and then he says my vibhuti is endless. Similarly here, Vidya Vinaya Sampanna, you think a person has so much of Vidya. He was not born like that. Maybe he was born like that. If he was not born like that, he trained himself with Vidya. And Vinaya came with humility because he has studied Dharma Shastra. He does not have pride. So you respect the person. And there you see Vibhuti of Bhagwan. He himself has manifested as this guru or whoever it is, Vidya Vinaya Sampanna. So Vidya Vinaya Sampanna Brahmane. And not only that, Gavi also, with Gau also, if you look at a cow, if that Samadarshina, these people look at cow also as a manifestation of same Brahma. Samatva Darshana is there. That Brahma Darshana is there. Tattva Darshi is, how do they see that? Tattvam Katham Pashyanti. That Gau is also Tattva. That Gau is also Brahmana. Hastini. So Hasta Asti Asti is Hasti, Hastini. So one who has a hand, everyone has a hand, but it is not a hand, it is really a trunk. So Hasti is an elephant. So towards an elephant also they have Samatva Buddhi, they have vision of equality. That same Brahmatma is appearing as an elephant also. What about a dog? Shunichayiva. Even with respect to a dog also they have the same idea. Now Brahmana has been said, and Gau, Hasti, and Shuna has been mentioned. What about Shvapaka? Shvapaka is a chandala who eats a dog. So this is all Upalakshana. So it all sorts of extremes and something in the middle with various kinds of sattva, rajas, gunas have been taken, tamo, tamo guna ityadi, and some sampling has been given to stand for everything, for a collective. Thereby, Shvapakecha, one who eats a dog eater also, Panditaha Samadarshinaha, they have a same Samatva Bhava towards everyone. Vidya Vinaya Sampanne, Brahmane. So, starting from Brahmana, and one who is outside the Varna Vyavastha, Chandala has also been talked about by saying Shvapaki. So all others in between are included. Gavi, Hastini, Shuni Chaiva, Shvapake Cha, Panditaha, Samadarshinaha Bhavanti. Yeah, we'll keep it as it is. Samadarshinaha Bhavanti, we can add. So there is a Purva Paksha to this. Nanu, an objection is raised. Abhujyanha te doshavantaha. Those who have these kind of, see, these are seeing equality where equality does not exist. You take a case in modern age where somebody has been, a group of people have been invited for something, some program in front of quite a crowd, and then they have to be rewarded. So when they have to be awarded, you don't give everyone the same reward, right? There is gradation. Somebody who is more qualified for qualification in science you are rewarding someone or somebody who has earned got more marks for that, for a rank holder, for some percentage, earning some percentage in an exam. For all these, there is gradation. So there is a vyavastha. You can't give somebody who has got 35 marks and pass, and somebody who has got 97 marks, you can't give the same reward. It is insulting. Similarly, somebody who is a PhD or somebody who has done great service to the nation, all these people cannot be treated similarly. In the same fashion, you cannot treat them. They have to be given respect. You can't put the servant and the king together and treat them both and this in the same manner. You can't call the servant a king and you can't call king the servant. That is not samatva bhava. In vyavastha, in vyavahara, you can't do that. It is insulting. So one may feel good about it, the other will feel insulted, and it is not right. Thereby, even in even when the Veda parties are invited for some kind of a homa or yajna or some festivity also, then dakshina has to be given. How do you give dakshina? Dakshina should not be given to everyone in the same manner. Dakshina also should be given looking at the qualification. What is the participation? For what purpose you are invited? Whom? You can't give some brahmacharis, you can't give the same bhojana dakshina as the main priest. All that is not right. And those who treat everyone equally and insult the person or the people who are more deserving by giving them less and treating them like others, what does the shastra say? Abhojyanaha te doshavantaha. Those who are doshavantaha, doshavan, these kind of doshas of samatva, samadarshana is a dosha. Treating everyone equally is a dosha because you have insulted one who is more qualified. Thereby you have got dosha, you have got papa, and thereby you become abhojyanaha. Abhojyanaha means people, those who follow dharma, they will not eat with you. You will never be invited to a pankti bhojana because you are insulting them. Thereby the shastras itself makes a vyavastha that whoever is more qualified should be given more respect, should be given more dakshina. So one who has studied one Veda should be treated differently from one who has studied Chaturveda. And that vyavastha is there through and through. Somebody will call people who follow dharma as casteist. You say you are a casteist, but they do the same thing with qualification. Do they give everyone the same salary? Do they treat everyone failure and someone who has passed in distinction? You cannot do it. That is the vyavastha. Thereby, somebody who has more scholarship and so on. So vidyavinaya sampanna brahmana cannot be treated like a shvapaka. That is not right. Thereby, abhojyanaha te doshavantaha. And for that, what is the pramana? There is a smriti which says samasamabhyam vishava same pujataha. So I'll not go into details of this because I need to know the entire thing what is there. But what it says, sama and asama. Through samatva and asamatva, if you vishava same pujataha. So during puja, if vishama is differently and sama is similarly. So if you, where samatvam has to be there if you do vishama as in asamatvam, and where asamatvam has to be followed, there you do samatvam. And the context is given during a puja. Then, so this becomes, when whatever is done during puja, that is dharma, and preferably this should be carried forward into society. That's whatever is done in puja, if something has to be said that this is the process to be followed, you should not eat something or you should not do something which is improper during puja, that becomes a social order also in Sanatana Dharma. Thereby, this should be followed. And now you are saying Samadarshinaha, Vidyavinaya Sampanna Brahmana as well as Shapaka is saying, a dog is same as a cow. Dog is not same as a cow. So you keep the dog away from everything. If a dog enters the house, you have to do shuddhi. Shuddhi karya in dharma shastra, dogs should not enter a house. Whereas a cow, you bring a cow for all pujas, you need a cow. You start with the cow. you need Gomutra, you need or Panchagavya. For all that, cow is important. How do you say both are same? And Hasti also is not same. In a kingdom, the elephant has a great value. You cannot say that the one king has 100 dogs and another king has 100 elephants. Both are not same. So there is the difference. So thereby, there is a vyavastha, sama samabhyam vishama same pujataha, iti smrute what? Doshavanta, te doshavanta, avojyannaha bhavanti. They are avojyannaha. Thereby, what you are saying is incorrect. This is not something which should be followed, is the Purva Paksha. To that the answer given is Nate Doshavantaha. They don't have these kind of defects. Who? The Samadarshinaha, Panditaha, Samadarshina Pandita, Tattvam Katham Pashyanti, Samatva Bhava. They do not have these kind of issues with what Smriti says. Why? Katham? How so? That is answered immediately by Bhagavan Krishna himself in the next shloka. इहैव तैर्चितः सर्गो येषां साम्ये स्थितं मनः निर्दोषं हि समं ब्रह्म तस्माद् ब्रह्मणि ते स्थिताः. बिकॉज ऑल दिस व्यवस्था व्हाट यू आर सेइंग इज राइट, दैट इज इन व्यावहारिक सत्ता. वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट व्यावहारिक सत्ता, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द पारमार्थिक दृष्टि ऑफ अ ज्ञानी. ज्ञानी डज नॉट मेक भेदा देर इन हिज विजन, ही सीज ओनली ब्रह्म. देयर बाय इह एव तैहि पंडितैहि, इह एव हियर एंड नाउ, इह एव तैहि पंडितैहि सर्गः जितः. सर्ग इज दिस जन्म, दिस संसार जन्म इज जितः, इज वन ओवर, दिस जन्म हैज बीन वन ओवर बाय देम. बाय हुम? हु आर दीस? सो येषां साम्ये, साम्ये ब्रह्मणि, इन दैट ब्रह्म विच इज साम्य समत्व, दैट ब्रह्म विच इज यूनिफॉर्म थ्रू एंड थ्रू अक्रॉस दी manifest prapancha and unmanifest. It is the same Brahma, unchanging, nirguna Brahma. Yesham samye brahmani manaha sthitam bhavati. Mana is sthitam. Manaha sthitam bhavati. Neuter, therefore sthitam. Manaha is neuter. Nirdosham. What is that Brahma? Nirguna Brahma is nirdosha. How can you say Brahma has dosha? When you say that jnani pandita has dosha, doshavantaha panditaha, Panditas are those who have Samyak Darshana, Brahma Darshana and Brahma Nishta. Thereby they are Brahma, Brahma Veda Brahmaiva Bhavati or Brahmavid Brahmaiva Bhavati. So these Panditas are those who are remaining in Brahma, they are in the form of Brahma, they exist as Brahma, they don't have any other existence in Vyavaharika Satta. They have no association with the Shariras at all. Whereas in Vyavaharika Drishti, what you are seeing is Sharira. You are seeing a Brahmana Sharira, you are seeing a Shvapaka Sharira, you are seeing Go Hasti and the Sharira of, what was the other, Go Hasti and Shuni Sharira. So, Shuna Sharira. So, you are seeing Shva Sharira. You are seeing a dog, you are seeing the sharira of a dog, you are not seeing the atma of the dog. That atma is not being objectified, but you are in vyavaharika satta. What you are objectifying is not what they are seeing, because they are cognizing Brahma, they don't have any bheda, they are Brahma, they are samabrahma themselves. Thereby, yesham samye sthitam manaha, they are nirdosha Brahma, that nirdosham hi. Manah nirdosham hi samam brahma. Brahma is nirdosha and thereby pandita is also nirdosha. See, the answer given is Brahma is nirdosha. How can that be an answer to pandita becoming na doshavantaha? For panditas not becoming doshavantaha, the shloka is saying Brahma is nirdosha. Let Brahma be nirdosha, but how is it that an answer to katham panditaha samadarshinaha pandita doshavanta katham na bhavanti? For that, what is the answer? Brahma nirdosham. So there is vaishamya if panditas are not Brahma themselves. Otherwise, that is not an answer. So the answer is that Brahma, panditas are Brahma, Brahma is nirdosha, therefore panditas being Brahma, panditas are nirdosha and thereby na doshavantaha. दिस इज हाउ इट हैज टू बी अंडरस्टूड इह एव तैः सर्गः जितः दिस सर्ग संसार वेयर ऑल दिस दोष ऑल दिस कम्स एंड एक्रूज ऑल दैट हैज बीन वन ओवर बाय देम एंड येषां साम्ये ब्रह्मणि मनम स्थितः भवति निर्दोषम ही ब्रह्म समम ब्रह्म इज निर्दोष एंड तस्मात् ब्रह्मणि ते स्थितः दे रिमेन इन दैट निर्दोष ब्रह्म दे हैव बिकम ब्रह्म दे रिमेन इन दैट दे डू नॉट गेट कैरिड अवे बाय अनात्मा एंड accrue the flaws of the samsara. They don't have such issues. They remain in, they have nishtha in this nirdosha brahma. So he is yasmat here. Yasmat nirdosham samam brahma nirdosham bhavati tasmat brahmani te sthitaha. तैः इह एव सर्गः जितः येषां साम्ये मनः स्थितम् तैः इज देयर स्टोनन गोल्जी थी येषां साम्ये स्थितम् मनः स्थितम् भवति येषां मनः साम्ये स्थितम् भवति मनः साम्ये स्थितम् भवति तैः इह एव सर्गः जितः भवति एंड निर्दोषम ही मीनिंग यस्मात् समं ब्रह्म निर्दोषम यस्मात् निर्दोषम ही समं ब्रह्म और वी कैन से समं ही समं ब्रह्म नो लेट इट बी दिस वे निर्दोषम ही समं ब्रह्म यस्मात् निर्दोषम समं ब्रह्म और यू कैन इवन डू दिस निर्दोषम समम ब्रह्म ही या इट्स ओके ही समम ही ब्रह्म निर्दोषम समम ही ब्रह्म निर्दोषम मीनिंग ही इज यस्मात् देयर तस्मात् ब्रह्मणि ते स्थिताः एंड ते स्थिता मीनिंग दे आर इन ब्रह्म मर्ज इन टू ब्रह्म एंड दे आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ब्रह्म ब्रह्म इज नॉट सेपरेट फ्रॉम देम देयर बाय दे आर ऑल्सो निर्दोष यस्मात् निर्दोषम समम ब्रह्म आत्मा वॉट इज दैट ब्रह्म आत्मा अदरवाइज दोज हु आर स्थिता आर डिफरेंट दे आर नॉट डिफरेंट दे आर सेम एज देयरफॉर आत्मा इज ब्रह्म तस्मात् देयरफॉर एंड ब्रह्म इज व्हाट इज सम एंड निर्दोष देयरफॉर न प्रहृषेत् प्रियं प्राप्य नो द्विजेत् प्राप्य चाप्रियं स्थिर बुद्धि रसं मूढः ब्रह्मविद् ब्रह्मणि स्थितः देयरफॉर गोज फर्दर एंड सेज दैट प्रियं प्राप्य न प्रहृषेत् हैविंग अटेन्ड प्रिय सो प्रियं प्राप्य न प्रहृषेत वन शुड नॉट बी इलेटेड बाय अटेनिंग समथिंग विच इज डियर टू वन सेल्फ सो राग द्वेष वन शुड नॉट इंडल्ज इन हैविंग अटेन्ड प्रियम वन शुड नॉट बी हैप्पी वन शुड नॉट गेट कैरिड अवे एंड अप्रियम च प्राप्य हैविंग अटेंड अप्रिय ऑल्सो न उद्विजेत वन शुड नॉट फील डिप्रेस्ड अबाउट इट देयर बाय स्थिर बुद्धि वन हु इज स्थिर बुद्धि इज अ पर्सन स्थिरा बुद्धि यस्य स स्थिर बुद्धि एंड असम्मूढ वन इज नॉट डिल्यूडेड नॉट बीइंग डिल्यूडेड बाय दिस प्रिय विषय प्राप्ति और अप्रिय विषय प्राप्ति देयर बाय सुख दुख इज नॉट देयर फॉर दिस पर्सन ही डज नॉट गेट कैरिड अवे बाय दिस विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू प्रिय एंड अप्रिय ही हैज स्थिर बुद्धि दिस इज समत्व and that is the samatva here. Yasmat nirdosham samam brahma atma, therefore being that samam brahma in that form, having attained that nishtha, whenever priya is prapta or apriya is prapta, that time being sthira buddhi, his buddhi is sthira, it does not have ups and downs, there are no sukha dukkha vrittis that hijack the person. Asammuda, he is not deluded. Thereby Brahma with Brahmani sthitaha. This Brahmani sthita, he remains where he was in Brahma itself. Brahmani sthitaha. Apriyam prapya na udvijayate. प्रियं प्राप्य न प्रहृषेत, अप्रियं च प्राप्य न उद्विजेत. स्थिर बुद्धि ही सन असम्मूढ़ः, स्थिर बुद्धि असम्मूढ़ः सन ब्रह्मविद ब्रह्मणि स्थितः. सो हियर let's see if Bhagavan gives something more. Bhagavan Bhashyakara, this is 19th, is it? प्रश्न कुरिया प्रियम इष्टम प्राप्त लब्ध्वा न उद्विजय प्राप्त च प्रियम इष्टम लब्ध्वा देह मात्र आत्मदर्शन क्रिया प्रिय प्राप्ति असंभवात किंच सर्वविषय समूह वर्जित सैत यथोक्त नथिंग एल्स इज देयर. All that he is saying, that one who is an ajnani, he will have this priya, what he said here, deha matratma darshinam. He priya apriya prapti harshave vishadau kurvate. This priya and apriya prapti, attainment of desired and undesired, these respectively bring harsha and vishada only to those who think of deha as atma, as oneself. For them alone it is possible, otherwise not for others, not for jnanis. That is what is said here. Kincha brahmani sthitaha, what has been said here, brahmani, brahmavid brahmani sthitaha. Brahmavid here, who has nishtha, brahmani sthitaha, bahya sparshesha saktatma vindatyatmani yatsukham सब ब्रह्म योग युक्तात्मा सुखमक्षय अश्नुते. सो दिस ब्रह्मणि स्थित ब्रह्म विथ हु इज नॉट ज्ञानी मात्र, ही इज नॉट समवन हु हैज जस्ट ज्ञाना बट ही हैज निष्ठा ऑल्सो. जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट प्लीज. So is Brahmavit jnani is one who has nishtha, that kind of a jnani, brahmani sthitaha jnani, bahya sparsheshu, when there is bahya sparsha for the sthula sharira. Asaktatma is a vairagi, one who has no connection with or asakti, one who does not have asakti in vishayas, then when these vishayas come in contact, shabda sparsha, rupa rasa gandha, these are the bahya sparsha. Sparsha is an upalakshana. Whenever there is contact with any object, that time a person who does not have asakti, that asaktatma, atma here is antakarana. So asaktatma, one who has no interest in this vishayas, atmani yat sukham vindati, A vairagi has sukha in atma, in oneself. Not atma, atma there is a reflexive here. Atma in antakarana, not reflexive, in antakarana, that is antakarana. Yat sukham atmani vindati. That sukha which he experiences in antakarana, in oneself. So if you take in oneself, reflexive will also work. What sukha, that sukha which he has anubhava of in oneself. Who is that? Vairagi, asaktatma. Yat sukham atmani vindate. What about that? Yat sukham vindate. So it has becomes a yat and sukham becomes karma to vindati. Vindati. Saha brahma yoga yuktatma. This vairagi, one he becomes brahma yoga yukta. Brahma, when his antakarana has this brahma yoga yukta, he is being connected with this brahma, meaning not being separate from brahma, having nishta. Once this vairagi has become a jnani and then he knows brahma as atma, thereby brahma yoga yukta, he is endowed with this brahma yoga, his antakarana is endowed with this brahma yoga. Brahma yoga yukta atma san akshayam sukham ashnute. Vairagi has some sukha, but then this vairagya is not continuous. Sometimes there is this vairagya may not be continuous, and then even then there is vishaya which he sees separately from himself, thereby there is break in sukha. There is gradation in sukha, because vairagi may not have vairagya with everything, towards everything. Or even if he has vairagya towards everything, it is only vairagya towards objects which are experienceable in this sharira. So one may deny oneself pleasures of this world for prapti of pleasure in another world, for swargasukha prapti. That is possible. Thereby in Taittiriya Upanishad, the second adhyaya, so there the gradations of shariras are given, and vairagya towards those particular shariras are mentioned, and thereby the ananda being multifold in each higher upadhi is mentioned, a hundredfold increase in upadhi, ananda in a particular upadhi, which can be experienced in a particular upadhi has been mentioned, and a vairagi towards that ananda, or towards vishaya sukha which is bhogya in a particular sharira, if a person is a vairagi towards that, then he attains sukha of the hundredfold sukhas compared to that, which is possible in another sharira, a higher upadhi. So such gradation, ananda mimamsa is mentioned there. So similarly here, a person who is bahya sparsheshu asakta, asaktatma, that person, what sukha he attains, atmani sukham, that same sukha which is akshaya, akshaya means it does not have any gradations, that is limitless sukha, the similar, but it is not, it is akshaya, which is not going to exhaust, that kind of sukha, because it is swarupananda sukha, that brahma yoga yuktatma ashnutehi attains. बाह्यस्पर्शेषु असक्तात्मा यत् सुखम् आत्मनि विन्दति सः, दैट सेम वैरागी व्हेन ही हैज ज्ञाननिष्ठा ब्रह्मयोग उक्तात्मा सन् अक्षयम् सुखम् अश्नुते. Akshayam sukham ashnute, he attains that kind of a sukha. So this is 21st shloka. We'll see more in the next part. Om Shanti Shanti. Any questions? Okay. No questions. I'll see you in the next part. Huh? Thank you.